Dear friends and students, accountancy chapter number 2, dual effect and types of account. So how to find out the accounts from the transactions, and we can apply the debit credit rules, and with the use of that we have to make a journal entry. 10,000 goods purchased for cash. When you purchase the 10,000 rupees goods for cash, so first is goods account, another is cash account. Goods is a real account and cash is also a real account. When real account is there, real account rule is what comes in is debited, what goes out credit. So goods comes in, that's why it is debited. Cash goes out, that's why it is credited. So goods account debited, cash account credited. But when we record, we don't want to write the cash account, goods account. But we have to write purchase account. So purchase account debited to cash account credited. That entry we have to be record now. Now the next is the second transactions. Sold goods of rupees 8,000 for cash. When you sold the goods, the two words are there, sold goods and cash are there. Now when we sold the goods, and another word is cash, we have to think about cash. Cash is a real account. When you sold the goods, cash comes in. Yes, it is comes in. That's why it is debited. Cash comes, that is debited. When you sold the goods, it's also real account. The goods goes, when you sold the goods, goods goes out. That's why it is credited. So as per the real account, cash comes in, cash account debited to sales account credited. So we write down the journal entry like this. Now the next third transaction is salary paid. Rupees 5,000 on cash. When you paid the salary, two account as the salary account and cash account. Now salary is a nominal expenses and cash is a real expenses. When we have a real account, first we think about real account. When you paid the salary, cash comes in or cash goes out, it means cash goes out. Cash humse jata hai, humare paas se cash jata hai. When cash goes out, that is credited. So cash account is credited. Salary is expenses. As per the nominal rule, expenses account debited. So that's why salary account debited. The entries are salary account debited to cash account credited. 5,000. So we can write this entry like this. Now the next transactions. Wages paid rupees 8,000. It's also same. Wages account and cash account. Wages is a nominal expenses. And cash is a real account. So as per the real account, cash goes out, that's why it is credited. Nominal expenses account always debited as per the nominal. So that's why wages account debited to cash account credited. The journal entry is like this. Now the next is furniture of rupees 40,000 purchased. Furniture of rupees 40,000 purchased. Nothing is written about cash, so purchase on cash. So the entries are furniture account, and by default nothing is written in the word cash, or nothing is written about the name or something, then cash word is there. The furniture comes in, that's why as per the real account, furniture comes in is debited. Cash goes out, that's why as per the real account it is credited. I'm not write down here furniture comes in, cash goes out, that we have to thinking now. The furniture account debited to cash account credited. 40,000. This is the real transactions. Now the next is rupees 80,000 machinery sold. 80,000 machinery sold. So no words is written about the cash. So by default cash value is there. So we are sold the machinery. So machinery we are sold, and by default cash is there. So when you sold the machinery, first we think about the cash. Cash comes in or cash goes out as per real account. When you sold, cash comes in, that's why it is debited. So cash account is debited. When you sold the machinery, machinery goes out, that's why machinery account credited as per the real account. So cash account debited to machinery account credited. Now the next transaction is goods of rupees 20,000 purchased from Ram. So goods of rupees 20,000 purchased from Ram. So this is the first is goods account, and we have purchased from Ram. So we have purchased from Ram. Another account is Ram account. because cashier is not returned. We have purchased the goods and RAM account. Two accounts are there, purchase account and RAM account. When goods purchased, goods comes in as per the real account. Goods comes in, goods account debited. That's why purchase account debited. RAM is a personal account as per the rule of personal. Those are the giver, that account is credited. When we purchase the goods, RAM is the giver. That's why RAM account is credited. So purchase account debited to RAM account credited. Now the next is furniture of rupees 15,000 purchased from Rajesh. Furniture of rupees 15,000 purchased from Rajesh. So then it is furniture account and Rajesh account. We have purchased from Rajesh on credit is. Furniture comes in as per the real account, it is debited. Rajesh is a personal account. As per the personal account, Rajesh is the giver, so it is credited. So now furniture account debited to Rajesh account credited. This is another journal entry. Now goods of rupees 8,000 sold to Rohini. When we sold the goods to Rohini, look at here. When we sold the goods to Rohini, goods account and Rohini account. We sold the goods. It's a real account. Goods goes out. So when you sold the goods, goods goes out. It is credited. That's why it is sales account credited. When you sold the goods, Rohini is the receiver. So that's why Rohini's account debited. Receiver account debited as per the personal account. So Rohini's account debited to sales account credited. This is another journal entry. Now the next is rent has paid 300 rupees. Rent is paid and cash, because rent is paid, it means it is by default cash word is there. By default cash word is there, so we have to understood as a paid by cash and a rent. Rent is a nominal expenses. Rent when you paid, it is expenses. Expenses account always debited. That's why rent account debited. You paid cash, so cash goes out, is a real account. So real account credited. Rent account debited to cash account credited. Another word, dividend received of rupees 11,000 on cash. When you receive the dividend, another first is cash account and dividend account. When you receive the cash dividend, cash comes in as per the real account, cash account debited. And dividend is an income now, as per the nominal account, income account is credited, so dividend account credited. So now you have to just do the practice of these sentences, then you understood properly.